Class 8 students, today we shall take up the new lesson, that is chapter 7, Asia, location and physiography. Okay, so as you know, Asia is the largest continent in the world. So continent means huge land masses are known as a continent, and this continent Asia, it makes up 30%, okay, 30% of the earth's land area. And the two most populous countries, China and India, are located in Asia, making it the world's most populous continent. Then another point with that is Asia makes up the eastern part, okay, eastern part of the Eurasian supercontinent. Now what do you mean by Eurasian supercontinent? So it's a combined landmass of Europe and Asia, is known as Eurasia. Okay, combined landmass of Europe and Asia is known as Eurasia. So the eastern part of Russia is a part of Asia. The eastern part of Russia is a part of Asia, whereas the western part is the part of Europe. The western part falls under the continent of Europe and eastern part falls under the continent of Asia. Okay, so Eurasia means it's a combined landmass of Europe and Asia. Now let us see the location. So in terms of location, that latitude, okay, in terms of latitude, it lies mostly in northern hemisphere, except for few like Indonesian archipelagos, okay, which are located in the southern hemisphere. So rest all, it falls under the northern hemisphere. And in terms of longitude, okay, it's located in the eastern hemisphere, okay, except for a few part of Asian Russia, okay, which is a part of western hemisphere, or they fall under the western hemisphere. So that is in terms of location. Now let's see the latitudinal and longitudinal extent. So as we know already, they lie in the northern and eastern part of the world. So in terms of latitude, it extends 10 degrees south to 80 degrees north latitude. And in terms of longitude, 25 degrees east to 170 degrees west longitude. Okay. Now the next point is, Asia is also called the land of, or the continent of contrast. Now why it is known as a continent of contrast? So it's due to its fascinating, attractive, okay, geography, culture, language, government, tradition and many other aspects. Now see the like few examples. Number, the first point is the highest, okay, the mountain point on the earth, that's Mount Everest, and the lowest point, that's a Dead Sea, is in Asia only. So highest as well as lowest point, the Dead Sea, both they are in Asia. Then another point is Arabian Desert. It's a hot desert, whereas Gobi is a cold desert. So both are in Asia. Okay. Then culturally also, Asia is the most vibrant continent. So because of all these features, all these aspects, okay, Asia is often referred to as a continent of contrast. Then the next point is, Asia is divided into six regions based on location. So on the basis of the location, Asia is divided under six regions. So east, north, central, southeast, west and south Asia. Number one, East Asia. Okay, so here you have the Eastern Asia. So it's also known as, this particular region is also known as the Far East, and it is the most populous region in Asia. So the countries here are Japan, North Korea, South Korea, Taiwan and China, and China is the largest country in East Asia. Then the second one, we have North Asia. Okay, so here we have the Northern Asia. So Northern Asia or North Asia is also known as Siberia, and as you know, Siberia, this is a region which is extremely cold. Okay, it remains cold for most of the year, and it includes Russia and Caucasus. And Caucasus means it's a mountainous region, okay, which is located between, you can see here, the Black Sea and the Caspian Sea. So it's located between the Caspian Sea and the Black Sea. So it's here. So this is about your North Asia. Okay. Then the third one, the third region is your Central Asia. So here, this portion is your Central Asia, and it includes mostly deserts, mountains and
plateaus. So Central Asia mostly comprises of deserts, mountains and plateaus. Then next one, Southeast Asia. So this particular region falls under a Southeast Asia, and this particular region, it has many islands, okay, and it includes Myanmar, Thailand, Vietnam, Malaysia, Singapore, Philippines. And this particular region, Southeast Asia, has large rice farms. Okay, they are well known for rice farms. Then the next one is your Western Asia. So here you have Western. It's known as a Middle East or crossroad of the world. Now, why it is known as a crossroad? Because the three continents, okay, Asia, Africa and Europe, come together in this particular region. That means in West Asia. So therefore, it is known as a crossroads of the world. And the countries here are mostly Bahrain, Iraq, Iran, Israel, Kuwait. Okay, so these all countries come under your Middle East, known as a crossroad of the world. And the last one is your South Asia. Okay, so this particular region falls under Southern Asia, and it is mostly made up of mountain chains, including the Himalaya mountain. So Mount Everest, which is a part of your Himalayan mountain chain, is the tallest in this particular region, that South Asian region. And the countries here are India, Nepal, Bhutan, Bangladesh, Pakistan, Tibet, Maldives and Sri Lanka. And among this country, India is the largest country. So here's a map work. Okay, so let's try to locate the continent. So as you know that Asia lies almost, okay, it lies almost or mostly in the northern and eastern hemisphere. It covers around 8.7% of the earth's total surface area, that is 30% of its landmass. Okay, so in the north, Asia is so broad, okay, that it covers almost the entire globe. So here you can see in the map itself, isn't it? So in the north, it's so broad that it covers almost the entire globe. And in the south, it does not exceed much beyond the equator. So here you can see in the south, the land masses covered by the continent very less. Okay. Then next one, let's see the lines of latitude, okay, that passes through Asia. So there are three lines. So first one, Arctic Circle. You can see here, Arctic Circle. Then next one, you have Tropic of Cancer and Equator. So these three lines, okay, these three lines, that's Arctic Circle, Equator and Tropic of Cancer, passes through Asia. The physical map, the mountains, seas and all. So the Ural Mountain and the Caspian Sea. So here you have a Ural Mountain. This is a Caspian Sea. So Ural Mountain and the Caspian Sea separates Asia from Europe. So this side is Asia and to the west is your Europe. Okay. So Europe and or Asia is separated from Europe by Ural Mountain and the Caspian Sea. Then next one, in the northeast. So if you check it out here, in the northeastern portion, the Bering Strait separates Asia from North America. Okay, Asia from this side is your Asia, and then here you have North America. So Asia and North America, they are separated by Bering Strait. Now Bering Strait means, strait means it's a stretch of water body, okay, that separates two land masses, but it joins two water bodies. So Bering Strait separates Asia from North America. Okay, then now let us see the water bodies surrounding the continent. First let's see the oceans. So Asia is surrounded by oceans on three sides. So first one, you see here, Arctic Ocean in the or to the north, the Pacific Ocean to the east, and Indian Ocean to the south. So three oceans surrounding the continent are Arctic, Pacific and Indian Ocean. Now let us see the other water bodies surrounding the continent. Okay, so first let's see the Red Sea. So Red Sea is here, it's a water body. Then next one you have Arabian Sea, then you have Bay of Bengal, then you have South China Sea, then after South China Sea you have a Yellow Sea. Okay, then after Yellow Sea is the Sea of Japan, then you have Sea of Ostok. So these and the Bering Sea. Okay, so these